So with this knowledge, I would like to share a quote from the book Hit Brands, How Music Builds Value for the World's Smartest Brands. It's funny how music works, because music happens in the end, when companies have exhausted all their money on location, products, and visual design. All this adds up to music being random and last minute. When it comes to music, brands want that perfect track, but want to pay the cost of a Skoda instead of a Ferrari. So Lauren, how true isn't this statement? How many times haven't we heard it? And what are you guys at Man Made Music doing to increase the value of audio branding?
Yeah. So, story of my life. And when you read that quote, I have to laugh a bit, because I think it is something that we all talk about. And what's funny is clients are aware of it as well. You know, they talk about it. They realize exactly. It. I think the world has changed over the last couple of years. And I think that has to do with the rise of podcasting, the rise of streaming audio services, how those media channels from a cost perspective versus television, and how linear television is changing so much, and that television advertising has a different value and a different media buying plan. I think this is shifting. And clients are now really understanding how important a sonic strategy is. Partially, that also has to do with digital experiences and how prolific they are becoming. So the fact that now you need to think so hard about how a digital experience sounds, ADA guidelines, designing in a way that is intuitive and works for people with disabilities has been so critical as well. So I think we're getting there. And I think it's becoming a point where that's not always the case. When it comes to actual music, I agree. And, you know, there's something so powerful about the song that everybody loves and knows in terms of how does that hit your brain? There's already a familiarity. Data has shown that you're more open to the message if you have that familiar sound to it. But familiar, like really big hits from current times or past times, cost money and do cost and should cost money, because they are borrowing on the equity of what the artist and the sound created and affecting your perception of the message in a very real way. So I think that these are conversations that we need to continue to have. It goes to the value of intellectual property. And how do you value that intellectual property? And people need to realize that you're not purchasing a song or a track. There is a lot of effect that comes with that song and track that somebody worked very hard to create. So you are purchasing that effect as well.
Yeah, I feel you. I got goosebumps, because this is exactly what I say. Even if I'm not a producer or creator myself, I worked in the event industry for many times, and a lot of people were saying, even my sister, but that is not a job. And it relates, I relate very much to artists then, that a lot of people say, oh, but you should work for free. It's not a job, it's just a performance. And when I used to work in like in-store music research, then I would tell, for example, restaurant owners, I said, oh, well, okay, but let's say I come into the restaurant, I have a meal, and then I just walk and go, like, oh, I will call the police on you. Yeah, but you're using somebody's work for free. The music you're playing is somebody has created it. But unfortunately, radio and all these free platforms have made it just like available. So they're not thinking about the hard work that it's behind it.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's funny, I think I tend to have this conversation a lot as well. My accountability partner for Man Made Music, her name is Ida Miriam Davis from Decolonized Design, frequently talk about the intellectual property of women, and specifically women of color, and how it's so critical to say, like, you know, my intellectual property, including music, sound, and creation, is incredibly valuable. And for Man-Made, when we get to that sonic brand, that theme or that logo or that suite of sounds, we're looking to create something that's going to last 10 years before it needs to evolve. Mm. But the attribution and the recall should still be there from a melodic perspective, from a textural perspective, whatever it is that we're using to create what it is that we're creating. So it's not about 2 to 3 seconds of sound. It's about a major piece of brand IP that should last decades. And so, you know, when we have conversations about costs, I think I've really had to work hard to talk to people about like, what is the value that we're looking to bring? And if you want to put something at the end of a campaign that's going to run for 13 weeks, maybe we're not the best choice, because at the end of the day, like, our goal is to create something that's really going to last.